Candace is this spunky, sort of vivacious girl. She's a college senior, and she's interning at her father's company, which is how she gets involved with the other characters. And she's kind of like a daddy's girl, you know, like definitely gets what she wants often. In the premonition is we get off the bus and we see that the bridge has just collapsed right in front of us. And so everyone starts running, but Candace is kind of just a little shell-shocked for the moment. And then all of a sudden, the bridge cracks underneath her feet. So she's forced to run it towards the direction of the guardrail. And then all of a sudden, she realizes that she's separated from the rest of the group as parts of the bridge are falling all around her. And then it's in that moment that she realizes she's not gonna make it. It's a very universal theme, death. You know, it's not specific to one, you know, race, gender, or nationality. It's, you know, everyone on Earth is forced to deal at some point with this theme, death. But also, I just think these movies are so fun, and it's kind of a bonding, communal experience for the audience to watch them. You know, everyone shares in, like, the laughter and some of the dark humor. And also, you know, the anxiety of like, when, you know, how is this person gonna die? When are they gonna die next? It's sort of it's a bonding experience. It's gonna make the film so incredible to watch because it'll really bring the audience into the story. I mean, a bridge is not just falling, it's literally falling on top of you, the audience member watching. But being on set with the 3D, it made me realize how talented these crew members are and that every tiny thing matters and you have to be such a perfectionist. Like, even my flyaway hair is a huge problem, and the hairstylists always have to be constantly aware of, oh my gosh, is there a flyaway? Because it'll look like I have some hair spearing out to the audience.